What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to be going over how to use the Rust Admin Panel plugin. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Choosing to host a Rust server most of the time is going to involve using uMod plugins, which can allow owners to add custom features. Some of these include admin privileges, such as teleportation, god mode, and more. But almost every plugin requires you to enter chat commands, which can turn out to be quite the hassle. That won't be a problem anymore, though, because with the admin panel for Rust plugin, all you have to do is click a button in a GUI menu to execute them. Let's go over exactly how to install and use this addition. Head to the Admin Panel plugin on uMod's website, and to the right-hand side of the page, press the Download button and save this file somewhere easily accessible to use in just a minute. Next, you'll want to head towards your Apex server panel, stop the server, and then click FTP File Access near the top left, log in, and then find the Oxide directory and enter it. After that, you can enter the plugins folder and then click upload in the top left corner. And then on the next page, you can drag and drop the downloaded file into the upload area. Wait for this to reach 100%, and then you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel and restart the server. Before joining the server, you're also going to want to make sure you're set to be an admin, which we do have a guide to that I will have linked down below. After this, you're going to want to join the server and use Oxide commands to add the admin panel allowed permission. This is going to grant you the ability to see and use the admin panel, which is near the top right corner of the game. Once everything is set up, you're going to see a certain amount of buttons based on any other plugins you might have added to the panel. Here is a list of some popular ones that'll add more buttons to the panel, and you'll want to install all of these plugins in the same way that you installed the admin panel plugin. Once you've installed some other plugins, you're going to notice more buttons available in the top right corner. All you have to do is click on one of them to initiate the add-on's functionality, such as enabling God mode with the God button. Using player administration as an example, selecting this option from your list in-game opens a new menu. In this area, you can ban anyone despite them being online or offline, and there's a complete list of banned users that's accessible in the GUI. Make sure to have each plugin's permission assigned to your account, since this is required to even view them in the admin panel. These permissions will cover the main plugin and its available add-ons. Adding all of these to your account through Oxide commands is highly recommended, and doing this requires you to enter the following command into your server's console. You should get a success message and be able to see the functions in-game. But if you can't, you might have to run the /admin panel show chat command to apply the changes. Of course, instead of just the panel itself, you also have chat commands available. Here is a list of all of the options that you can use. If you're wanting to make changes to the button style, then you're going to need to edit the plugin's configuration file. Head to the FTP file access from your main server, log in, and then you can enter the Oxide and then config directories. Find the admin panel file and press edit to the far right. And here you can make any of your desired changes and then click save at the top. Return to the main panel and restart the server to apply any of the edits. If the admin panel isn't working, make sure uMod support is checkmarked in the customizations from the main panel, and then make sure you've assigned admin panel allowed to your account and that you've made yourself an admin. If you're unable to see any buttons, then remember you must install the other plugins to have the buttons appear in-game. You're also going to need to assign their respective permissions to your account before you're able to use them in the GUI. There are quite a few steps, and it's definitely going to take some time to set up your admin panel the way that you want to, but once you do get it working, it really changes the way you manage your game. Having the buttons is way easier to navigate than having to remember commands to use in the chat, and you'll be glad you took the time to set it up. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.